Hi, this is a Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about why it's so important to do actual physical device testing. Okay, so this week I want to talk about testing. More specifically, I want to talk about device testing. Now, it's one thing as a software developer or as an app developer, it's easy to like use an emulator or a simulator and just do everything, you know, on the desktop. In fact, you can even make an Android app using the simulator alone and never have to actually have an Android device. However, the problem with that is that as soon as you get on an actual device, a lot of times you run into trouble. So it's best to have physical devices around to test on. Now, for us, now I have, like in front of me, I have a whole bunch of devices. I've got, you know, several iPhones. Well, this is an Android. It's my Nexus 5. I've got my iPhone 6. I've got my iPod Touch 4. I've got an iPad Air. I've got the Nexus 10 tablet. I've got, you know, and I'm always buying more and more devices. In fact, you know, the Google Watch is the latest thing, which is, you know, it's kind of cool. But you know, The reason why I say testing on a device is important is because if you've ever done anything where you've released an app and haven't tested on a device, you find out you have different kinds of issues. To give you an example, we released an ebook last year for Christmas, and what happened was everything worked fine in the simulator, and I didn't really do any device testing. I could have done because I had all the devices, but you know, I guess I was kind of lazy. And when we put it on the device, we found out it ran into memory errors. And the reason for this is, like, even though the iPad simulator on the Mac OS, it works exactly the same way. It doesn't support like push notifications, but it does support, you know, all the things that an iPad does. So it's really good for testing. However, it has all the power of the MacBook. So once we got it onto an actual physical device, it crashed. So it would crash from memory warnings on a certain page. So it was kind of embarrassing because I actually put it through the App Store, and it was Apple who actually rejected it. So from then on, we have to test on physical devices. Now with iPhone, that's easy because, you know, iPhone's pretty standard. You use the latest version of iOS. They're really good about upgrading, so you don't have to do that much testing. Now with Android, you know, it's like, you cannot, it's an unwinnable battle. You will never get, you know, test everything. There's too many, there's thousands of devices out there. All the operating systems, you know, you still have people out there with 2.3, although it's getting better, Android 2.3 and upwards. So like with EarSpy, you know, we get crashes, crash reports all the time on Google Play, but it's just something we have to put up with. Now, if it's significant, you keep an eye on it. If it's significant, then we will investigate. But sometimes, like, people say, It could be anything, because it's so difficult to troubleshoot these kind of things. Like with EarSpy, there's some people who say that it doesn't work on the Galaxy S4. However, other people say it works great on the Galaxy S4. So you never know. We're trying to go by comments and stuff like that. You don't know if it's, like, you know, just their how they expect the app to work, or whether they're doing something wrong, or if it's genuinely crashing, so and not raising a crash report. So however, there are services out there. Now, last year I used a service called AppThwack, APPTHWACK, which was really, really good. And what it will do is it will upload your Android file or your iPhone IPA and upload it to the cloud, where they have like all these different devices, and it will run the app on all those devices and give you screenshots of how it looks on each one of them, which works really well. Now they've recently been bought up by Amazon, so they have a whole new Amazon Web Services cloud farm kind of thing, which I'm going to check out soon. But so there are alternatives to doing actual device testing, but you should have at least one device. If you're doing iPhone and Android or whichever, you should have at least one physical device in order to test on. Now, what you shouldn't do is go out there and buy like the top of the range, because most of users might not have top of the range, especially with Android. Android is the cheap mobile phone, so you should look lower down on the spectrum and get something like like a $100 phone or £100 phone, and test on that. So that's it for this week. My advice this week is you cannot rely on just emulators alone. You have to do some device testing. So, and believe me, I've been burned by it several times before in order to know better. So that's it. So that's it for this week. Now, just to let you know, we do have a blog. So we publish several blog posts a week on www.overpass.co.uk. They're really good. You can register for the newsletter so you don't miss anything. So just to keep you informed. And thank you so much for all the comments. I know somebody commented recently saying that we need to go deeper with the topics. I'll work on that. I'll work on some deeper topics. Thank you. I think it's Tarsus Studios. So anyway, that's it for this week. I'll talk to you next week. Bye. Hey, I really hope you liked that video. Now, I do these once a week, so if you want to hear more, or you want to hear more about our experiences with the App Store, either Google Play or iTunes, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and please like this video and leave a comment. I love reading the comments. I love hearing what you have to say, even if it's just hello or whatever. And like I say before, if you're not sure what to say in a comment, like I never know what to say in a comment, I'll make it easier for you. Like if you liked it, just go ahead and say gnarly, which is an 80s term. Or if you didn't like it, just say bogus. And if you didn't think any of it, just say eh, right? So that would be a big help. And another thing you could do, which I'd really appreciate it, if you're on the App Store and you want to try one of our apps, look up some of the Overpass apps, applications, either on iTunes or Google Play, and leave a review and let us know what you think about it, either good or bad. But, we're all trying to, build up in the market. So that would be a big help. So that's it. I'll talk to you next week.